Hello friends, welcome back to my channel Deep Biology. In this tutorial, you will be learned about a modern structure of an antibody or immunoglobulin. As you know, the human body is capable of synthesizing more than a million different kinds of immunoglobulin molecules, each capable of reacting with a different antigen. But all of them appear to share the same fundamental quaternary globular structures. And these structures of antibody are most important to design a specific vaccine to against any particular antigens. It may be bacterial origin, fungal origin, or some other things. And therefore, to understand a model structure of antibody is very much important. Let's see its structural organizations. Typically, an antibody or immunoglobulin molecule is Y-shaped in structures. It has two identical heavy chain and two identical smaller light chain. Each arm of the Y-shaped structure has a complete light chain and a part of heavy or ACE chain. The leg portion of this Y structure possesses a part of heavy chain. Near its C terminus, each light chain linked to the heavy chain by disulfide bond. Two additional disulfide bond linked to this link to heavy chains in the each region. The H chain possesses in its tail segments antigen determining sites by which immunoglobulins can be classified as IgM, IgE, IgA, IgD, or IgG. Each with its own class of ACE chains as gamma, alpha, delta, and epsilon. Light chains likewise be treated as kappa or lambda. This nomenclature is given due to their gene organizations in the light chain. Within a heavy chain or light chain, C terminal segment exhibit a little variation in this area. And it is known as constant region. This area is known as constant regions. And while amino terminal parts of both heavy and light chains are extremely diverse and call as variable regions.
and these variable regions contain antigen binding sites where epitope or antigen determining sites are held in. D. Variable region of heavy chains and light chains. The variable region of heavy chain and light chains together form antibody combining site for specific interaction with a homologous antigen molecule. This site is responsible to interact with homologous antigen or epitope molecules. Each Y-shaped antibody has two identical antigen binding sites. Each antibody molecule has two identical antigen binding sites on every tip of the each arm. This is the site for antigen binding. Because of the two antigen binding sites, antibody are said to be due to these two antigen binding sites, antibody or immunoglobulin molecules are said to be bivalent. The efficiency of antigen binding and cross-linking of antibody is greatly increased by the flexible region. The efficiency of antigen binding and cross-linking of antibody is greatly increased by the flexible hinge region. This is hinge regions. It gives an antibody to flexibility. This gives antibody flexibility to perform its functions. An antibody that if subject to proteolytic enzyme pepsin can split antibody molecule into different characteristics fragments. Two separate and identical Fab each with antigen binding sites. Each of the four polypeptide chains of an immunoglobulin is also divided into repeating segments called domain. This is a domain. Light chains have two domains. Light chains have two domains, whereas each chain have four domains, that is variable S regions, constant S1 regions, constant CH2 region, constant H2 region, constant H3 regions. Antigen binding site is formed above. This antigen binding site is formed above 20-30 amino acid residues in the variable regions of both light and heavy chains. The variability in the variable regions of both light and heavy chains is for the most part restricted to these smaller hypervolume regions in each arm. The variability of both heavy and light chains are only restricted to this hypervolumic variable regions of each arm. The remaining part of the variable region is known as framework region. The remaining part of the variable region is known as the framework region. Are relatively constant in comparison to hypervariable regions of the variable parts. That means the light chains and heavy chains put at each arm having two regions, antigen binding area, are variable regions, and this part is constant regions. Among variable regions, this specific area are known as hyper variable regions, and other remaining part of variable region is known as framework regions and are relatively lower variable in comparison to hypervolumic part. Those part of antigens combined, suppose this is an antigen, those part of the antigen which are combined to this antigen binding sites, this part of the antigen is known as antigenic determinant or epitopes. So this is all about and structural organizations of model molecular structures of immunoglobulin. This is important to know a model structures of immunoglobulin, because if we want to develop a vaccine to a particular pathogens, this antigen to develop this antigen binding site is most important. Thank you for listening me. In the next tutorial, I will give you different types of antibody like IgG, IgM, IgD and its specific role in human body. See you again.